Hi, my name is Beth Murphy, and I'm the director and producer of the documentary film Beyond Belief. It has been really exciting to share the film with the E-Town community. I have really enjoyed my experiences here. The more that I learn about this community and the campus, I'm just so impressed with what you're doing here. The emphasis on service, the emphasis on, you know, what it means to be a global citizen and how you can achieve that. I really think, I mean, if I could go back, I would love to be a student here. Is that possible? Will you take me at this ripe old age? The film, you know, the reason that these, the principles that you live by here on this campus are so meaningful to me is that, you know, these are very much the same themes that I like to address in my work, and in particular in Beyond Belief. This documentary film follows two women who are widows. They were widowed on September 11th. Each of their husbands was on one of the planes that was flown into the World Trade Center towers. They were both pregnant on 9/11, and when they lost their husbands, you know, they really, I mean, the grief was extraordinary, but so was the outpouring of support that they received from across the country, from around the world. And they felt so bolstered by that support and that love, and they realized that as great as their tragedy was, their day-to-day lives weren't really changing all that much. They were staying in their same homes. Their children were still going to good schools. And they started to learn about what life was like for women, and especially widows like them, in Afghanistan, where the terrorists had trained who killed their husbands on September 11th. And they realized that for women in Afghanistan, once they lose their husbands, I mean, that's really the beginning of the end. That's the unraveling of the whole life. There is no life insurance. They're often kicked out of their homes. They can't work because widows aren't really allowed to work in Afghanistan. And should a widow in Afghanistan want to remarry, she would often have to leave her children with her husband's family. It's an unconscionable choice for a mother to have to make. That's why oftentimes you see in Afghan society that once a husband dies, the woman often marries a brother-in-law. And often becomes a second or third wife of that brother-in-law, so that she can stay within that family structure and keep her children, and also, you know, retain the benefits of having a man in her life so she can do things in society. So, you know, it's an interesting time to be showing the film here, you know, really so close to the 10th anniversary of September 11th, such a historic time in our nation's history. And to really, you know, think about ways of connecting with the world. And I think, you know, Susan and Patty, the two women who are featured in the film, are such an excellent example of what it means to connect with our world in a really meaningful way, and to build relationships with people, you know, to build these, you know, very, you know, real and metaphorical bridges with another society that seems so different than our own society. You know, and the reality is Afghanistan and the Afghan people, they are different than we are. And it does seem on the face of it that we have so many differences, and that makes it easy, I think it's easy to focus on the differences ultimately. But when we focus on the differences, it's so easy to become indifferent to people and to their plight. And, you know, the reality is, while these differences do exist in our societies, we are very similar. We want the same things out of life. And, you know, that's what Susan and Patty discovered as they went to Afghanistan and they met the widows there. They discovered that although they spoke different languages and came from different socioeconomic backgrounds, they were able to communicate because of their shared widowhood, their shared womanhood, their shared motherhood. And with that shared language, they were able to have just, you know, really amazing and beautiful conversations. And so I'd like to think that, you know, for people who are able to see the film, and I hope you have an opportunity to see it someday, that there's the message is that we as individuals can act on the world stage and make a difference. And, you know, I think sometimes we see so many of the world's tragedies and it becomes really, just difficult to comprehend how we could affect any sort of change. There's a real kind of feeling of helplessness or hopelessness when it comes to these bigger issues. But when we start to think about, you know, connecting one-on-one with someone, then it's like, all right, you know, I get that. I can see how that, you know, I that makes sense to me. And I think that's, you know, really what it takes. So, you know, as you're here, you know, at school and focused on the incredible message of service that is such an amazing guiding principle here, I would, you know, suggest in this realm that the service is possible, and that if you want to, for, you know, when it comes, I'll talk specifically about the film and the issues addressed in it, that, you know, you have an opportunity now to raise awareness. You can use the film to do that. Bring it home, show your parents, show your siblings, show your friends at home, and raise awareness about the issues in Afghanistan, and, you know, raise awareness about the plight of women and widows in Afghanistan. And if you have the means or the desire, certainly you can, you know, help to raise money. You can use the film to do that, to raise money to support the incredible programs that Beyond the 11th is doing in Afghanistan to help lift women and widows and their families out of poverty. Thank you very much.